Hi guys, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to install Ubuntu alongside Windows 11 for a dual boot setup. This is perfect if you want to explore Ubuntu while keeping your existing Windows system intact. Don't worry, it is easier than it sounds, and I will walk you through every step. So let's get started, okay? So before we begin, here is a quick checklist for what you will need for this installation, okay? So first, we need a Windows 11 PC with at least 50 GB of free space, a USB drive minimum 8 GB of creating a bootable Ubuntu installer, Ubuntu ISO file, and Rufus bootable USB creation tool. Once you have gathered all of this, let's move on to the step-by-step guide, okay? So first, we need to download the Ubuntu ISO file. So open your favorite browser and you need to search for Ubuntu download. From the search result, open Ubuntu official site. On the home page, you will get the latest version, which is 24.04.1 LTS. This is the latest LTS version of Ubuntu as of now. Okay. So here you need to click the download button and your download will start automatically. As you can see, the size may be around 5.8 GB, so it might take some time depending on your internet speed. You need to wait for the file to finish. I have already downloaded that file earlier, so I'm going to stop this downloaded process. And this is the downloaded ISO file. Next, we need to Rufus software. So for that, once again open your web browser, and this time you need to search for Rufus download and visit the Rufus official website. Now scroll down little bit and you will get a download section. And here you can download the portable version of Rufus. This version runs directly and does not require installation. Okay, so it's a very small site, so within a fraction of a second, file gets downloaded. Great. Now we have Rufus and Ubuntu ISO file ready to use. So let's create a Ubuntu ISO bootable USB, okay? Make sure the USB drive is at least 8 GB in size and it does not contain any important data, as Rufus will completely erase it during the process, okay? Now you need to open Rufus and insert the 32 GB USB drive into the PC, and you will see the USB drive is detected automatically. Now click select and choose the Ubuntu ISO file you downloaded earlier. Here, I am going to keep the partition scheme as GPT, as my system uses UEFI BIOS, okay? You can also choose MBR if you have a legacy BIOS. Now, keep all other settings as default and click on Start. Rufus will warn you that all data on the USB will be erased. Confirm by clicking OK. Rufus will now create the bootable Ubuntu installer. This process might take some time depending on your system speed and the size of the ISO file. Once the process is complete, you will see the ready message with a green background under the status section. That means it's completed. Now click on close button to exit the tool. Before we install Ubuntu in our system, we need to make some space on our hard drive. So for that, right click on the start button and select disk management. And here you need to find your Windows drive. This is basically C drive. So right click on it and select shrink volume. Now you need to wait for a few seconds here. You need to decide how much space you want to allocate for the Ubuntu. I am going to make it 100 GB for that. Okay, so I need to open my calculator and 100 into 1024. That means 102400. So I am going to enter the amount 102400 in MB and click shrink. This will create an unallocated space of 100 GB where Ubuntu will be installed. Now right click on this and select new simple volume. Then click next. Again click next. Then assign the drive letter for this space. And click next. Set a volume name. Suppose I'm going to name it Ubuntu for easy identification. Then click on next. Then click Finish to create the space for Ubuntu. Now it's time to boot your system using the Ubuntu USB and install the OS on it. Okay. So for that, right click on the Windows icon and then select Setting. From the left hand menu, click System. Then you need to scroll down and select Recovery. Under the Advanced Startup section, click Restart Now. Again, click on Restart Now. After restarting, you will see a blue screen with advanced options. Here, you need to select Use a Device. Then click on your USB drive and your system will boot into the Ubuntu installer. And this kind of dashboard will appear now. And here, you will get different kind of options. And you have to click on Try or Install Ubuntu. The Ubuntu installation page will appear now. And here, select your desired language from the list and then click on Next to proceed. Then the Accessibility Options page will open. Here you can select any option based on your needs, such as seeing, hearing, typing, etc. If none are applicable, simply click on Next to continue. Then choose the keyboard layout and click on Next. And here make sure to connect to the internet. If possible, use a wire connection for better stability. Okay. And then click Next. Now we are being asked how we would like to install Ubuntu. Since we are beginners, we will go with the interactive installation. This option is perfect for users who want a guided step-by-step process. If you are more advanced and have an auto install configuration file ready, you can opt for the automated installation instead. Okay. For now, with the interactive installation selected, let's hit Next to proceed. On this page, you will be asked to choose the apps you would like to start with. The default selection is already set, you can see, including essential web browser and basic utilities, which is suitable for most users. Okay. There is also an extended selection that includes offline tools, but for now, stick with the default selection. Then click on Next to proceed. On this page, you are being asked to install recommended proprietary software. It's a good idea to select both of these options as they can help improve your computer performance. Go ahead and click on Next. Next, you will be prompted to choose the installation type. Select the option to the install Ubuntu along with the Windows Boot Manager. Keep this option selected and click on Next to proceed. Now, it will ask you to install Ubuntu alongside the Windows Boot Manager. This screen will show all the available drives on your system. Now here, you need to select the correct drive where you want to install Ubuntu. Click on Next to proceed. Now, you will need to enter your username and password here. You can choose any name you would like for your username. You would like to change the computer name. You can do that as well. Okay, so pick a username for your Ubuntu operating system and then you need to set a password for the same. And again, confirm the password. And once you are done, click Next to continue. It will prompt you to select your country or region. So choose your location from the list. Then click Next. Here, you can review your choices and finally click on Install. Now that the installation process has begun, it could take anywhere between 5 to 7 minutes in my case, but don't rush, take your time and let the Ubuntu do its things. So be patient and wait for the installation to complete. Okay. Once the installation finishes, you will see a message saying installation is complete and it will prompt you to restart the computer. So go ahead and click Restart Now. You should now see a message saying please remove the installation medium. That means it's safe to remove the USB drive that you are using to install Ubuntu. Okay. So once you have removed the media, go ahead and press Enter to continue. When the computer restarts, you will be presented with a screen asking whether you want to boot into Ubuntu or Windows 11. If you select Ubuntu, it will load into Ubuntu. And if you want to boot into Windows 11, simply select Windows Boot Manager. So let me show you both options here. So first I will select Ubuntu. After that, it will ask for the user account where I need to enter the password I just created. and the Ubuntu desktop will appear with welcome screen. You need to click on next. You can also skip the Ubuntu Pro enable options. If you want, you can share the system data with the Ubuntu team, otherwise select no, don't share system data. Then click on next. Then click on finish. You now have the Ubuntu desktop up and running, ready for you to explore. You can start working on it or test any application you like. On the left hand side, you will see an icon labeled App Center. Open it up and you can search for various apps. By default, Firefox is included as your web browser, but if you prefer another one, you can search and install it directly from the App Center. And under App Center, you will also get the terminal. Now, if you want to boot into Windows again, you will need to restart your system. So to do this, click on Start button, then select the power icon, and then choose Restart from the menu. As your system restart, you will see the boot menu appears on the screen. And this time, select the Windows Boot Manager from the options and hit the Enter key. And your system will boot into Windows 11. You can see, now we are in the Windows 11. That's all for today's guys. Hopefully this video helped you successfully dual boot Ubuntu and Windows 11. If it did, don't forget to like and subscribe. See you in the next video. Bye bye.